Speakers up, blasting through your airwaves. Stressing through the week, but now it's hump day. Whether at home or riding through your city, it's always gratitude when you're lounging lyrically. Trying to justify it in the midweek minute. Screaming blessings up to the black on business. We really love our fans and their energy. The message is vibe over everything.
What's going on, everybody? I want to welcome y'all out to Midweek Vibe. I'm your boy, Cobain. That is Draper Winston.
I am.
And it's Wednesday.
Shit, it is. Three digits Wednesday. Fuck, it hit 108 today. I don't know if y'all were inside. I hope you were inside when it hit 108 today, but goddamn, it hit 108. That's some bullshit.
No, it really is. Really is some bullshit.
That's some bullshit. That is 108.
That's why I stay my ass in the house.
Shit. Any place that got a fan that's cool, just relaxing, relax, all that shit, man. I got to be indoors. Like, it's between the heat, monkeypox, and COVID, man, it's going to keep people in the fucking house. And I understand.
Well, yeah.
No?
Yeah.
You don't think so?
I mean, you know, it's a lot of shit going on in the world. And they ain't not shutting this shit down no time soon.
No, they ain't shutting this shit down no time soon. And they ain't even thinking about shutting this shit down.
At all.
So I don't even know why we even know who we fooling. You know, who we think we fooling that they don't shut the shit down. Because they knew what happened last time they shut this shit down. Shit, motherfuckers was like, oh, for real? Oh, I can stay at home?
Look.
And get paid?
Listen.
Shit.
Next shutdown. What up, CO? Next shutdown or whatever. I'm filing unemployment. I'm getting all the fucking duckets. Hell, y'all were getting 10 grand a fucking month off that shit.
Man, it was chilling. It wasn't doing shit.
And then y'all tried to double back and get the PPP, which Joe Byron. Joe Byron, he just extended that fucking the fucking bill.
Well, you know, Joe Byron trying to make a comeback. Don't call it a comeback, but he trying to make a comeback. Because he talking about, you know, canceling those student loans. He talking about canceling student loans. He said by the end of August.
Man,
he already canceled some, but he said he's gonna cancel the rest of them.
Man, that's fucking fool's gold shit. This motherfucker canceling ITT Tech and shit. Like, he ain't canceling no real shit. Bruh, motherfuckers got $200,000 worth of debt at universities. He's motherfucker going to ITT Tech.
Shit, going to fucking DeVry and shit.
DC College and shit.
Everest College on y'all ass.
It's like $25 a class and shit. Like, come on, look. people got the big pause. The
Say
big
please.
Fucking bills.
They got the big, yeah, pause.
You know? I'm just gonna leave it here before I get to the business. Ladies, y'all always ask, like, you know, shit, like, I bring everything to the table. Yeah, you bring a lot of fucking debt. So
you getting started already.
Bruh. Just saying. Look, you talking about you are the table, you right.
You are the table, huh?
Pause. The wood, the sap, the all that shit. 200 grand worth.
The glue. All that shit.
All that. You die, that shit transfers to me. Just saying. So, hello, Midweek Vibe is powered by Hello Studios right here in the heart of downtown Dallas. And it's a production of Bacardi Dallas. And Stillhouse USA. Ooh. Let the vibe go where the glass can't follow.
There it is.
Other than that, I mean, you know, I ain't got to say the fucking weather report. It's hot as shit.
Hot as a motherfucker, man.
It is. Even though, okay, I'll give y'all a little brother Shabazz real quick. The word is, don't take this from me. Do your research. The word is that the good old government and everybody is back up the business. CO, you know we are. You know I am, bro. Look, the government is back up to doing their business, you know, with the good old Heart Project, and Texas is supposedly, you see my air quotes. You know, I mean, if you're not online, if you can't, whatever. Just imagine me doing air quotes. That there's supposed to be a couple man-made disaster is coming.
A couple of man-made disasters
coming. Yeah. I mean, starting here in Cali. Starting here in Texas, and supposed to head to Cali, it's supposed to be a lot of, like, you know, tsunami-like, you know, floods going on. And they said Texas is supposed to be, you know, the first, which y'all dumb as shit because, okay, we stay in Dallas.
Like,
we stay in.
If you, all right.
I'll be comfy on my fucking couch.
We got closest bodies of water. We got is Jopu Lake and Lake Ray Hubbard. And I don't think them bitches going to tsunami any motherfucking
Listen,
body.
Trinity River, the Trinity River's not doing shit.
Hey, them ain't going to go nowhere.
The Trinity River's not doing a goddamn thing. Now, to all my Houstonites, to all my people, you know, and, you know, down there.
Galveston.
And South Padre and all that. Listen, do your research. Don't take Midweek's word for it. Do your fucking research. But if this is coming, pause. If it is coming. Pause again.
Again.
I was told y'all need to, you know, get your, not your affairs, but get your survival kits and, you know, your firearms and everything else, you know, together, you know, along with your kids should have a bag too. And all of your, all your documentation. Whatever. Cali, they've been saying, y'all, San Andreas, y'all going to break off from us, like,
yeah,
you know, for longer.
Eventually, yeah, they said eventually Cali's going to be its own island like Hawaii.
And they said New York is supposed to, well, actually, New York, y'all had a fucking glimpse because this was last year. Y'all had floods or whatever that nobody was talking about.
Which is true.
That was up to y'all fucking knees or whatever.
Yeah.
Almost your hip.
Yeah. We complain about the heat, but I ain't never been no big fan of large bodies of water anyway. So.
I'm a water sign. So
I'm okay. I think I'm an air sign, I believe. I think that's probably why I don't like the heat.
I'm a water sign. Let's just float. Let's just float through life and let's, you know, get this, you know, tranquility and the niceness going on right here.
Tranquility.
Feel the vibration of my voice right now. You know. Ping. All right, so let's go and look.
This nigga did his own bowl.
I did. I like that. All right, so where do I want to start? Where do I look? Fuck. All right. I'm going to say that shit for last.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to say that one for last because y'all out of fucking hand. All right, first off, man. I mean, sad news. Want to get out the way. Want to send our condolences, you know, to the, you know, to the football coach.
Oh, yeah.
You know. Who was, you know, shamelessly killed, you know, at a fucking Little League football game. Parents, stop trying to live your fucking life through your kids. I'm going to say this again. Stop trying to live the life that you did not pan out through your fucking kids. You had, look, your uncle and your grandmother, the only ones that believe you were going to the NFL.
That's it. That is it.
That's it. You were you were 6'3", 300 pounds in the third, look, no, not third, in fucking kindergarten, and you were running over everybody, and everybody had hopes. You didn't fucking make it. Sit the fuck down. Let these kids have fun.
Let them have fun, man.
Let them have fun. And we can sit up and talk about, like, where the shit started, and I have a pretty, you know, pretty good idea, you know, here in Dallas. I can say Mansfield, you know, as an example of somebody's parent was pissed off
Correct.
That their kid did not fucking make the team or whatever and went to the school board and asked for, like, well, petitions for other schools to open up, whatever.
Correct.
And in return, this is about the same time that you have all this, Let's get away from first, second, and third place to everybody gets a participation trophy.
Yeah.
And now everybody gets a, you know, a ring and all this. Fuck that. If your kid did not win, teach them how to deal with losing.
Teach them how to deal with it all. Teach them how to deal with winning. Teach them how to deal with losing. Teach them how to deal with the ups and downs of what sports brings.
Not to harp on like who we were sounding like, you know, Shepard and above the rim and shit. but I remember playing in the Whataburger tournament and we got second place And basically, my whole, like, the whole squad was like, fuck that second place trophy and your all, look, and my all-tournament trophy.
Yeah.
We did not win first place.
Yeah.
So, like, we can say the mentality and all this other shit has changed, but for the parents to get, you know, outraged and the fact that they jumped this coach.
Yeah.
They jumped him. And then I counted at least six rounds that were let off.
At least easy.
Easily.
Easy. And the problem that I have that stems from all of this, right, is for one, you know, we see the coaches fighting the referees.
Yeah.
You know, we see that, and then we see, you know, the parents fighting coaches and whatnot like that. And so we can't keep saying, oh, it's about the kids, it's about the kids. You know, I think that went out the window a long time ago. Now, there are a handful that do really believe that it's about the kids and they're really working for the kids. But then there's the handful that, like you said before, they're making it about them and what they didn't do, and now they're living their life through their child. And so to even – because the first part of the video, you see a coach is going off on a referee.
Yeah.
I mean, he's going in on this referee.
And the ref is trying to tell him, bruh, it's over.
It's over.
Let it go.
Let it go.
No, right? He.
Yeah, that's a bullshit card. That's this, and that, right? Then all of a sudden you see, you know, the fight break out and ensue, and – it's an all-out brawl.
Yeah.
At a little league kids game, right? And so I've sat in these bleachers, and it's hard as a parent because, for one, I've sat on the side as a coach. I've heard parents yelling at me. I've heard, you know, all that shit, right? But sitting in as a parent is like it's worse. I can't even sit next to him because I just hear him yelling and all that. And I saw this one time. This parent is yelling, put my kid in the game. That's why y'all losing. That's why y'all losing. Shit, they put his kid in the game. First play of the game, first time that kid touches that ball, that kid fumbles the ball, and they go and they score. The coach just turned around and looked, and that parent didn't have shit to say. And so it's like you try to keep fighting for your kid, but your kid don't want to fight for themselves and can't fight for themselves because you've always pandered them. And so therefore, now you got parents fighting, want to fight each other because you feel your kid is being done wrong. Well, your kid ain't being done wrong. Your kid is being taught. I got into it with a fucking parent. I did. At my son's basketball game because he was getting onto our coach. And this was the reason why I got onto him. I was like, these are 5 and 6 year olds.
Yeah.
These are 5 and 6 year olds. And you sitting here talking about, you yelling at the ref, you yelling at the other team's coach, talking about, I know the rule book. I said, say, man, we're not going to do this. I said, man, these is 5 and 6 year olds, man. Let these kids have a good time. And what was sad was his kid was one of the better kids. And that was the reason why the referee was calling it tighter on him, was because your kid is good. So I'm actually showing you your dumb ass. I'm showing your kid respect because your kid is good. And now you want to act like this. So his ass got tossed out.
Listen, when people seek advice from me in the sport, like in the sports realm, and, you know, yes, I have a lot of friends who, yo, like, you should, like, you know, put all that knowledge to use, come teach, you know, or show my kids something, or do this, blah, 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 and this, that, and the third. And the first thing that I tell them, let your kid fall in love with the game first.
First and foremost.
Listen, I've been through gyms, bro, and I mean we all have. Like if you're from that world, we've seen parents.
Yeah.
Why the fuck you got your kid going through a goddamn college individual at 5 years old?
Right.
Why?
Right.
Like that. Like there's no fucking reason why your kid should be doing all this shit at 5 years. Look for a benchmark for you parents who don't know and who are tuning in. Age 12, between 10 and 12,
mm-hmm.
between 10, say that shit five times.
Say that five times.
between 10 and 12 is the age that you should be starting to pay attention.
Yeah.
Your kid will come to you and tell you, if not, just have a conversation with them, will tell you
right.
that, like, this is what they want to do. This is what they love. This is like, okay.
Right.
And your response should be, if you are serious.
For sure.
If you're serious about it and this is what you want to do, then let's go after it.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to force you.
Right.
I'm not going to do, like, none of this other shit. Like, seriously. your time is up. And if I can put, look, if I can put it biblically for you Christians out there and like all this other stuff, God has something else for your life. He kept you away from the NFL, NBA, NBL, like, you know, Euro League. I can go down the fucking list. Canadian League, ABA, NBDL. Like all it, he kept you away from it for a reason. Because you have a greater purpose somewhere else, and it's not to force your fucking kid.
Right.
All right. And the biggest, man. and the biggest point out of all this is that he was killed in front of his 9-year-old son.
And in front of his son. In front of his son.
In front of his 9-year-old son, bro.
In front of his son.
Not only that, but he was a father figure for it, like not on his team, but a lot of in that league.
Yeah. Yeah. And what's even more like kind of, you know, when you think about it. Why the fuck do you have a gun on the field at a kid's game? Why? You're a coach, and you have a gun on the field on a kid's football game. What type of dude are you, right? What type of dude are you? Like, that just screams. That coward should be tattooed on your forehead.
Yeah.
If you feel the need that you need to have a gun on a football field or for a kid's football game, what is really going on with you?
My thing is, and for those that haven't heard, this is Aqib Talib, and his brother, who are Aqib Talib is a NFL vet. Mm-hmm. He played for at least 10 years. He was a cornerback, you know, and his brother, you got shit like a shit ton of money, or whatever. But they have been, you know, I don't want to say in trouble, but like they have been called into the league many times for causing a ruckus and causing, you know, mischief and whatever the case may be. But my thing is, like, look, we take like pops on Friday, nigga. Let's use these.
Whether if you lose, you get to fight another day.
You live to fight another day.
You get to fight another day.
get up, Craig. Craig, get up.
There you go, Craig. Craig, you got knocked the fuck out. If that was me, but it's to the point of, you know, this ain't, we can't say, oh, this is, you know, a Black Lives Matter shit. Man, this is just dumb, stupid shit.
It's dumb. It's stupid.
It's just dumb, stupid shit. And you doing it, man, I just can't get over the fact that it's at a kid's football game.
At a kid's football game, bruh. And the first thing that I immediately thought about, bruh, the day that I have kids and they're old enough, they're fucking, I'm not putting them in any fucking leagues and like that. Like, look, we're gonna go to the playground with daddy. Yeah. Look, you got all the uncles and the cousins, you know, around. Yeah. Look, you can play. If you love it, if you fall in love with it, whatever like that, then look, hey, I know all the fucking trainers.
Right.
We can get you there. Look, you drop all these niggas off in high school or whatever the case may be. You know, if they want to see you during the summer, they can come watch you work out against pro level players. But I don't know where they go from here. Like, you know, I know that somebody said like the league mm-hmm. should, you know, put in an extra fee, you know, to have security, you know, which is fucking sad that you have to have
cops
and security at a damn little league football game.
But think about it like this though, right? Cool. You got security, but you still got concealed handguns.
That's what I'm about to say.
You know what I'm saying?
You can't pat everybody down.
You know what I'm saying? You can't pat everybody down or try to make everybody walk through a metal detector, because in the end of this is a coach. Yeah. Most of the time the coaches come in through the back or they come in through an opposite entrance.
But this is outside of the field. So look, yes, you can make sure you can have security over there, but you're gonna have that one cat.
Yeah.
Like in White Man Can't Jump. I got y'all.
I got y'all.
Y'all stay right here. I'm gonna go to my car, get my gun, come back. I'm gonna shoot everybody. Shoot everybody. Like, I mean, you got crazy yeah. motherfuckers that's like that. And not to harp on this shit, like, you know, for the whole fucking episode, because we actually can.
Right.
It's just like, yeah, do fucking better, y'all.
Just do better. Like, honestly, because at the end of it, right, at the end of all this shit, them kids, now those kids are going to remember that game. The kids that were there are going to remember that game.
They're going to remember that game. And now you got to get therapy for all these kids.
Oh, absolutely.
You got a 9-year-old who's going to grow up with this disdain, first SAT word, nice. This disdain in his heart, because not only like he doesn't have his dad, but his dad was killed in front of him.
In front of him. Like, you don't think about the mental anguish that this young man is now finna go through, you know? And it's not fair. It's not right that at the end of the game, right, these kids are going to forget the game.
Oh, my God.
They are going to forget the game the moment that they get home, the moment that they get with their friends to play Fortnite. They're going to forget about this game, man.
All they fucking worried about, mama, where my Powerade and pretzels?
Where is my game day snack pack? Where is my game day snack pack?
Mama ain't getting no orange slices.
I ain't getting no orange slices, mama. who team mom's supposed to bring the fruit snacks today? Who's supposed to bring the fruit snacks? Kim, it was you. Kim.
That's all
they worried about.
That's all they worried about.
That's it, dog. That's it. And now it's the parents that are turning it more into more than what it really needs to be.
And I'll tell the last thing for these fucking parents. if you feel like that you still got hope and you still need to get that shit out your system, go try for a fucking team.
They got semi-pro teams that you can play for.
Look, Dallas has one. You got the Arena League.
Oh, they got a few of them. They got the Trojans. I saw another, the Spiders. It's a few of them you can go play.
Look, a few of you women. I think the Lingerie League is still around, too.
Surely.
Above that, they have a full contact women's football league.
Yes, they do.
If that's what the fuck you want.
Yeah, they actually got a full contact men's league, no pads.
Yeah.
So if you feeling froggy, go ahead and jump. Go ahead.
Stop putting these fucking kids in your goddamn dream.
Like, please.
That never panned out.
Please. Like, I mean, y'all know LeVar Ball was sorry, but shit, he ain't gonna fight nobody.
At all.
He just made his sons better. That's all he did.
He just talked shit, which is a part of the goddamn game.
It's a part of it. If you sensitive.
If you getting your ass whooped, go back to the drawing board or recruit better players.
That's it.
You know. All right, off of that, let's go ahead and get into this this next one, because I'm tired of you fucking preachers, too.
If I know where you're going with this, I almost brought this one up. All
right. You're right. I'm tired of you fucking preachers, too. You know, I ain't tired of your hustle. I'm just tired of you fucking preachers. Because, okay, we had Bishop Whitehead, you know, in New York.
Yeah.
You know, with the fake ass robbery. I mean, if you dive into that shit, that was a fucking insurance scam. Insurance scam, whatever, because I don't know who gets robbed and all this other shit, and then you come out with press conference after press conference after press conference.
Man, now, it's everywhere.
You making yourself look like a martyr, like I need to bring the mayor into this, I need to bring the president, all this other shit. And now you have this other preacher, which this is not uncommon. It's just that, you know, in the age of cameras and everything else, everything is, second SAT word, everything is ostracized.
Nice.
So this pastor in Kansas City, doing his sermon, you know, says, you know, calls his congregation broke, calls them pathetic, you know, and then goes on the little rut, you know, and says, what? Your McDonald's money ain't good for me. Your Red Lobster money ain't good for me. All because they didn't want to chip in and buy this man a Movado watch. A Movado watch.
And you know what's sad? A Movado watch ain't that much to get. I mean, you can get a Movado watch. I mean, I think anywhere from $600 to $1,000, depending $600 to $1,000, depending on which one you go for. But a Movado watch is not
at all
that much to get. And I mean, he's married, okay. But if he's preaching, I mean, what type of salary are you making that you can't buy your own Movado watch?
Listen, I'm gonna say this again. Churches are a 501(c).
Yep.
Which means that you don't have to pay taxes. You are getting funded by the government.
Yep.
So that means the building fund, the fix the doors, the air conditioning, all this other bullshit that they've been telling y'all for years.
Everything fund.
It's already fucking paid for.
It really is.
It's already paid
for. It really is.
So I'm pretty sure he saw Bishop Whitehead with the chains and the look in the Urus and the Bentleys and the, you know, and all that, and was like, listen, congregation. Y'all need to step up to the plate.
Well, I had to say it like that.
I know a couple.
Listen, congregation.
I know a couple of y'all done got the PPP. I know a lot of y'all are unemployment, and y'all are still getting the subsidized payments from the government. You know, it was a blessing that you got this increase. But the baskets are not overflowing whenever we go through offering. Now, I don't want to tell you what to do.
You got to lead in with that segue.
Yeah, yeah. I don't want to tell you what to do. But hey, I've heard some preachers say, right after that phrase, I don't want to tell you what to do. But if you don't give God his cut, he's going to take it.
They do say that. And it's pretty bad.
It's horrible.
And it's always been a discussion of the church. Right? It's always been a discussion of the church. Why is, you know, y'all, the church harps so much on money, tithing, and if you don't do this, then you're not going to get this, right? But that's one of the hardest preached parts in most churches. Now, so there's some churches that preach a little bit better on it, but most churches, they preach on the money. If you don't do this, give your portion to God, then you're not going to reap a benefit, right? And that's one of the furthest things from the truth, right? Because it doesn't necessarily say that you have to give your money to the church.
It doesn't.
At all. Like, that's where that line kind of gets told a little bit, is it never says give your money directly to the church.
Second of all, God wasn't in the church.
He was amongst the people.
He wasn't in the church. Right. All of his acts and generosity, third SAT word, all of his acts and generosity, say that shit
say
three
that
times.
One. Yeah, say that one.
Was amongst the people. Correct. Was to the people.
Correct.
Was to the poor.
Correct. Correct.
Not in the church. Bruh, like this, and then they wonder why people are gravitating away or moving away from the church.
Absolutely.
It has nothing to do with how God is portrayed, because no matter what your, you know, religion, creed, whatever, like, you know, God looks different to everybody.
Right.
He looks different to everybody. He's presented to, you know, to different cultures in different ways.
Right.
But it's the way that y'all are fucking up the, I want to say fucking up the church's money.
But
but I mean, seriously. It that's what it is, you know. And I'm not talking, you know, specifically on black preachers, because I've rolled over in my fucking bed at 3 a.m. and saw the telecast of these white preachers,
especially on BET.
Look. Oh my God. Everybody in different cultures around the nation, around the globe. Oh, God just put it on my heart. For 20 people to have $1,000 faith tonight, you know, he's sending it, you know, without resistance and, you know, with love and with joy. Just 20 people to have, and then like, hold on. So I'm sitting here like, okay, all right. This is one preacher, blah, 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 and then that telecast goes off, and in the first 5 minutes of the next telecast, whether that the same preacher is preaching the same thing.
Yep.
Look, we're just going to start this off early. You know, we're just going to have faith tonight that around the world, we just have 20 people that have $1,000 faith.
That's it.
That's it.
And if you don't have a $1,000 faith, we can activate your prayer cloth for more. We can activate your prayer cloth for free with the shipping and handling charge of $7.99.
No, and they go. And they, look, then they go to. If your faith is falling off, and it needs to be readjusted, we have the natural spring water.
It came in a ketchup package.
We have the natural spring water. For just a minor donation.
A minor donation.
Of $29.99 today.
Yeah, we're going to run a special on the natural spring water.
You will be automatically admitted into the prayer line.
No taxes.
Bro, like, so, I mean, look, so this pastor, and of course, so the picture that I chose, is of him apologizing.
Oh, man.
Yes. So he did this Sunday, and today is Wednesday.
Yeah.
And so he came out with this, I guess, this morning, or, you know, it had to be yesterday. Now, for those, is this thing on me?
It is on you.
This is how he looked while he reading that. Dear disciples, look at my eyes. Look, I'm coming to you with so much pain in my heart. I deeply want to apologize, you know, for the way that my words may have offended, you know, so many people around the globe.
Oh my God!
You know, those were not my intentions. You had to hear the entire. So he's reading off a piece of paper.
Wow!
Reading off a piece of paper, and so all the things that he's saying within that or whatever, and obviously on that post, y'all can go to the post or whatever. I ain't gonna tell you where it is. Ain't get nobody no shine. But if y'all go to the post, y'all can see my statement in which, you know, I say, translation. I saw the backlash I was getting. I wasn't trying to fuck up the church's money.
Yeah, I wasn't trying to fuck up the church's money.
You know, I had y'all hook, line, and sinker. You know, in the continued, you know, in the residual that y'all are giving me every Sunday, not only in the regular offering. But in the love offer, in the pastors, what do they call it? What do they call it? The pastors' offering, jeez. And in the building fund offering, you know, y'all were giving so graciously, and I didn't want to offend, you know, my congregation and everybody else, you know, for those that are tuning in, you know, on the InstaWeb, I did not want to offend you. Your money is valuable to me.
I'm
three-fourths away to my Movado.
Oh, my gosh. You got $200, goddamn. What type of church you running in? You got $200? And honestly, looking at, you know, and again, you know, social media can make a lot of things look different.
Yeah.
Look very different. But looking at the picture, looking at the background, looking at his church, it looks like it's a pretty nice little spot. So how in the world can you not afford that?
First off, you probably rent it out.
You know.
Like Bishop Whitehead. That ain't even his fucking, like, you're renting upstairs of a building, bro.
Oh,
You're renting the upstairs of a building.
Jeez, man.
So, like, your overhead is really nothing.
He's probably lucky
if he's paying $1,000 a month.
Or they doing, you know, like a lot of churches I used to see get started in the elementary school cafeterias.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So you can't be paying a whole lot with that.
No, you're not. Like you're renting it out.
Yeah.
You're renting it out. And I ain't clocking nobody's pockets. But you're renting it out. That's what you're doing. So, everything that you are, you know, you're requiring for these people. Yeah, we do got to catch up, Cam. Like everything that you're doing to require, like, for these people, you know, to like whether it's that, you know, keep like being up to date on the tithes.
Yeah.
You know, paying for this, paying for that. Like it's crazy. Like you're pocketing all of that.
Yeah. Yeah. And because you know, he got his overhead, but it doesn't look like he got a bunch of staff.
No.
It doesn't look like he got a bunch of people helping him run it. You know what I mean? I mean that microphone stand back there you can get from Amazon for $12. So I mean,
you probably blasting everything out on Zoom. was a Streamcast or something?
StreamYard or something.
StreamYard.
You ain't doing a whole lot, man.
No.
But to have the nerve and unmitigated gall, man, just to ask or demean the people that are supposed to be following you.
Yeah.
You know, to say because y'all didn't want to buy you a watch. You know, it's just.
Time talking about my McDonald's money. Man. Good. No. No. Lil Juju need a fucking Happy Meal. You think? Shit. No. Hell.
Juju need four-piece nugget meal.
Hell. Juju like the goddamn toy in the Happy Meal. It costs extra.
It costs extra. And I had to upsize the Happy Meal so he can be happier, bitch.
All right. So which leads me into this question or whatever. Has the church gone all about the bag? I'm going to say this again. Has the church gone all about the bag?
That's a great question. Now, so I'm answering twofold.
Okay. Right?
I'm answering twofold. So the first fold of it is that, yes, the church is gone. I think now, with the emergence of these social media pastors, God, dog, man. Like, the emergence of this social media pastor is like, that's what it's all about, because it's weird to me, and maybe it's because I'm from the quote unquote old school of the church, right?
Listen,
it's weird to me hearing these preachers saying, yes, for you to receive God's blessing, hit that like and follow button, and you can receive the blessings that you need. Like,
little boy Kale said, church has been about the bag.
And that's the second fold.
Yes,
it's a business,
but. Okay, so Cam and like Nancy, it's like so, business. they've always been about the bag, but back in the day, it was a little bit more discreet.
It was a little bit more discreet.
Listen, look, you had your doubts, whenever they do the offering at the end, and everybody stand up and everybody walk around the church,
yeah,
and then you have the ushers that compile all them trays.
Mm-hmm.
With all the dollars or whatever, and then you had the one that was counting. You had the one that was holding the envelopes. In the back of your mind, you were like, wait a minute. That's a lot of money.
Where they going with all that?
And then
every Sunday.
Hold on. And then two months later, we still working on the air conditioning.
Like, it's still hot?
The building fund, it's just one hole that's in the front of the church. We still working on that?
I know one of the knobs just fell off. You ain't fixed that knob yet?
Hey, I've been sitting on the same pew since I was 3 years old. It still got the same hole in the cushion that it did when I was 3 years old. You mean to tell me?
And Sister Jenkins' pew has been rocking for the past 6 years. Each time she sit down, that bitch go back, and then it come back forward.
Listen, we all got to be in unison when we sit on this pew.
But you know what? This was another way that these pastors would be discreet, right? The top tier cars that they would get would be a Cadillac.
Oh.
That was it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It would be a Cadillac. And it wouldn't be an Escalade, right? It would be the Cadillac sedan, whatever that was, CTS or something like that. But it was a Cadillac. You knew pastor's car was probably going to be a Cadillac of some sort, right?
Mm-hmm.
9 days.
Oh, my God.
It's Bishop Whitehead. They roll around in Cullinans and Rolls Royces and Uruses.
Listen, look, the lowest form of car a pastor got now is a Jaguar.
It's a Jag.
And that's a and I ain't talking about the regular old Jag
that X-Type. That S-Type that ain't got the Jaguar on the front no more. That's what he got.
Listen, let's go back. Let's start treating the church like when you become a cop. You got to be 5 years on the beat. Listen, your ass got to be 5 years with that look with that hot ass robe up under. They got the thing to go.
Yeah, man.
Look, You got the ruffles. It's too fucking big on the sleeves or whatever. That's why they had that rag. That's why they had that rag. Like, you know, wiping off all that damn sweat.
Yeah.
With that grape juice.
They need tiers of pastors now.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You need to escalate up to receive it. They need to treat these pastors like Mary Kay. When you get to a certain, get to a certain level, you get your Cadillac.
Cam just said from a CTS to a G5, all facts.
Facts. Like, it was unheard of for a pastor to have a private plane. Like, that was unheard of.
My thing is, bro, like, I mean, we talk about Bishop Whitehead, Pauls, and, like, some of these other preachers who have been, you know, subpoenaed. That's SAT word.
Yeah.
Who've been subpoenaed, Pauls, for, you know, for their expenses or what like that. Like, you're preaching in Gucci,
right?
Fendi, Prada, right. Louis. Right. Like, this is your closet.
Yeah.
Your closet costs more than the fucking room that you're renting out.
Which is true.
To stream across, you know, whatever.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, maybe a section in your closet. Like, remember Bishop Whitehead's closet? I mean, he had like a mini apartment, and at least what he had on the floor,
yeah,
probably cost, you know, what he was paying in rent. And so, think about it, at least even, they talk about Joel Osteen, right? They talk about him, but at least he wear the same blue suit with but that same solid tie.
But is it Tom Ford?
It could be Ferragamo, we don't know. It could be H&M. Hell, we don't know.
Hey.
We do not know. But at least he's trying to be somewhat discreet about it.
Look.
Right? And not being too loud. Now, listen, it could be tailored. We don't know.
Listen, let's take it back to the mob days. Never be the loudest nigga in the room.
Never.
Never.
Never. That was the whole deal.
Yes. And if y'all
didn't learn from American Gangster.
They did. Look, before that, all these motherfuckers like to watch Scarface. Like, that's the only goddamn gangster movie that, you know, Scarface. Which is, look, we can argue later. Scarface is a fucking horrible movie.
Scarface is bad.
It's horrible.
And I'm a movie guy.
Hey, look, first off, not to go on this little tangent in this rabbit hole, but first off, I had to get up and change the fucking VHS. Scarface, that's how long this shit is. It's two fucking VHSs. two tapes. Had to get up and change the shit.
It is. It's two tapes. And what's bad about it being two tapes is that it's like the story is almost 3 hours, 3.5 hours or something like that. It could be told in about 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Oh my God.
Like, it can really be told in 1 hour and 15 minutes if you want to be real about the movie Scarface.
Yes.
You know? And what I think as an actor, yes, Al Pacino was amazing in it as an actor. But the story and the storyline of it, there were some great lines. The world is mine, Chico. And I want everything in it. You know, there were some great lines in it. But the story.
All I have in this world.
The story was just too damn long.
That too fucking long.
Pause.
Shit. Just like. Never mind. About to say, yeah, but. Stop, preachers. Stop.
Yeah.
Stop this shit.
Like, it's getting out of hand. Listen, well, it's been out of hand, but it's getting way out of hand.
Listen,
now.
And I'm gonna go. You see, the voice is back.
There it is.
The voice is back.
And it's on you.
And I'm talking to the congregation right now. If you can hear the sound of my voice. Now, we talk about discernment, you know, and when you follow these false prophets.
Mm.
And, you know, these false idols, then your discernment will be led astray and you'll be off with the will of God, amen?
And we just don't know who to trust no more.
Hold on. You see, they always do that. And you'll be off, you know, with your discernment with the Lord, amen?
Amen.
Amen. And so.
You better respond back, amen?
I need for you all to trust. To trust who's most important, that's God. Don't put your faith in men. I need all of you to get back in line with the will, with the will of God.
Amen.
You know, I don't want you guys to be left at the pearly gates.
Amen.
With the comedian who be sitting there with all the fucking jokes on the first day. I love them shits. But no, but seriously, people, wake up. Wake up. Have a mind of your own. Now, yeah. I get it. If you just want to give your fucking money away, Yeah. I get it. But at the same time, have your own discernment.
Yes. Yes.
That little voice that little voice inside of you, pause.
You know.
Hear it speaking.
Yeah.
Hear it speaking.
Yeah. And you know. There's, you know, I can scroll on social media and I can hear, you know, one of these dudes, you know, and I'm like, nah. Yeah. I'm going to keep on, you know, scrolling and, you know, keep on moving because it's just, if someone is truly about the word of God and you know somebody's, you know, intent and heart. So
my thing is, before we get into these little, this other little, you know, preposterous story, if you're only supposed to have the faith of a mustard seed, why do I have to give you $2,000 in order for, never mind. All right, so.
I should be able to give you that dirty ass penny in my,
exactly.
in my middle console and keep on rolling.
Listen, I should be able to give you that, look, that dusty ass peppermint in my grandmother's purse with the penny attached to it. And that should be good enough. Yeah, you know, because that's all I have to give right now. That's all I have to give.
Man, I heard one pastor say this, and it really made me respect it when he said this, right? He said two things. He said, one, the building needs to be operated, right? So we do need funds to help keep the building operated, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what your funds are going to. You see the work that's happening with your funds that you're giving, right? Then he came back and said, if you're at your last, don't put the money here.
There you go.
And when he said that, I was like, oh, man. I feel you. I'm with you. Because it was that simple. He was like, don't put your money here if this is your last. Have faith in God, but let's not be dumb either. let's be smart.
There you go. So let's not be dumb, and let's go back to that first statement that you said. It's a 501(c), which means that they get grants and everything else in order to work on this building, which means that your money that you're paying to get this things fixed in this building is still going in the same purse. All right, so.
Boom.
Speaking of purses. We gave y'all the fucking story a few weeks ago of Balenciaga coming out with this trash can ass purse or bag. This trash can ass purse or bag. I bet not see none of y'all motherfuckers wearing that shit. I bet not. But okay, this shit is over the top. Like it's tenfold. This shit is egregious. So they've come back out. So Balenciaga has a new earring that's worth $250. If y'all just email vibemidweek@gmail.com with your orders, I will make these shits for y'all tonight. It is a fucking shoestring. It is a goddamn shoestring. The earring is a shoe. I'm gonna say this. The earring is a shoestring that they're charging y'all $250 for. $250.
At this point, I just think the designers of Balenciaga are walking around the house picking shit up and saying, let's sell this. Let's put Balenciaga on it, and they gonna fucking buy it.
Your next earring is right here.
There it is.
Right here. Your next fucking earring right here.
There it is.
Right here.
Right
you see
there.
This? Matter of fact, it's long enough. Pause. That's two fucking earrings.
That's two of them.
That's two of them.
Yeah.
That's two.
That's two of them. I think at this point, Balenciaga is just saying, fuck y'all.
It's not just Balenciaga. It's all the way across the board.
Oh, of course. Yeah.
Because Kanye West, with his Gap line, wherever that, he got pissed off at the fucking retailers for putting the clothes on hangers, bro, and on the racks.
What?
If you want Kanye West's line at Gap, wherever that, when you walk into the store, they're in big-ass fucking trash bags, which means that you got to dig through and find which one you want and find the actual size within there. It's not it's not allocated for you. It's not in chronological order by sizes. And by, you know, design, like, you know, with the jackets and shirts and everything. It's not put out there. It's all in fucking bags. It's all in bags. And you got to dig in the fucking bags. Hmm. And now Gap fucking hate me. God would hate me because I have all this shit all over the goddamn floor. It'd be, hey, I'd be throwing shit everywhere. No.
Nigga, you be the type to go in there and put your arms in the back, in the bin, and pull everything out and just lay it out there on the floor and just be like, ah.
I'd be treating that shit like the Nike factory store. Like, I'll pull 15 pair of shoes and I'll try to shit on. Ain't getting shit.
I don't want none of them.
I don't want none of them.
Nah, they don't fit me right. This is the line that has, like, the rips and the stuff in it, and the sweatshirts and stuff like that.
Yes. So when he had, like, quote-unquote, the giveaway or, like, the exclusive, you know, sale, you know, in Cali or wherever it was, he had all these shits in dumpsters. And them motherfuckers had to dig through the shit, you know. And every article of clothing is nothing but black anyway.
Anyway.
That's it. It's just black.
Anyway.
It's dusty black, regular black.
Ashy black.
Ashy black, crusty black, you know.
I just think at this point now when it comes to the whole designer, you know, phase, I just ain't big. Now, don't get it twisted. I'm not counting anybody's pockets, not counting anybody's, you know, taste. If you want to go buy whatever you want to buy, do your thing.
Yeah.
But as for me and my house, if it don't make sense.
Listen.
I'm just not big on it. You know what I mean?
Bro, this is a fucking shoe.
It's a shoestring.
A shoestring, bro.
Now, I do understand, like, some pieces, like, when I say, like, quality, like, but also, I argued with somebody about this, too. People be like, oh, but it's quality. Yeah, it's quality if you wear it once a year. Of course it's going to be quality. You don't give it no wear and tear, but wear that bitch every day.
Listen, Nike is the highest fucking quality that you can come across within the sports
realm. Yeah, absolutely.
If I wash my Nike sweats twice, them motherfuckers done shrank. Phew. I look like a seventh grader that has shot up 3 fucking inches. Just pause.
We need to go get you some more stuff, huh, baby?
Hey.
You just grew?
Hey, them motherfuckers right above the ankle. Them motherfuckers right above the... Yo, so, like, you talk about this great quality. God damn it, man. Look, stop.
That shoestring right there is at Target and Walmart right now for $1.73.
But you know what? I'm going to give y'all a little insight, and I know y'all have heard this before, and I'm going to say it again. These white fucking companies don't want you in their goddamn gear. And this is another fucking example. They're making you look stupid. They doing this shit on fucking purpose. They're doing this on purpose. Doing it on purpose. On purpose.
That's fucking sick.
Because black people want to keep up with the Joneses.
Yeah.
And
man.
So you want to buy all this shit as a fucking status symbol.
And to be honest, nobody's gonna know that that's fucking Balenciaga.
Nobody.
Like, oh damn, you got a shoestring on your ear. No, niggas be like, oh shit, you got a shoestring in your ear.
Listen, I'm going on Amazon today. And I'm fucking making.
I'm looking at it, and I'm looking at the structure of how they made it, right? So they tied it in a bow, right? That's very easy to put the little piece on the back, the little earring latch. That's very easy to put the little earring piece on the back, and you know, hot glue that bitch. You know,
that's all they're doing.
Gluing that bitch for you to
listen.
You know, put it in your hole, pause, and then keep on going.
That is it.
That's it. That's one of the most simple things. You know, I mean, if they thought that the trash bag was gonna work and people gonna go buy the trash bag, they gonna buy a shoestring.
Look, here you go. So Balenciaga gave y'all a trash bag and now they're giving y'all a string to put on your fucking ear just in case that the string won't close. So you can take the string and then you can tie this shit off.
Yep.
And throw that shit in the fucking garbage like everything else.
All of it. All of it.
All of it.
They're going to come up with a goddamn Balenciaga bread twist tie. Y'all going to be, all upset.
No, that's going to be a ring.
That's going to be a ring. Y'all going to walk around with bread twist ties on your finger. Shit. Talking about, oh, it's Balenciaga, though. It's Balenci.
You know what?
That's what they're going
to
say.
You know
it's
what?
Balenci.
You know what? The glass jars that you get to put, like, you know, the instant oats and the and juices and salad dressings, all this stuff in. They're gonna take the tops.
Yeah.
You know, look the inside panel, they're gonna take that shit out. That's your fucking bracelet right there.
Boom. There you go.
And
they're gonna say it's Balenci.
Yeah, that's it.
That's what they're They're going to say, it's Balenciaga.
Fucking ridiculous.
And y'all, so you know, and what's bad, somebody going to buy it just because it's Balenciaga.
Yeah.
You know?
Just because of the name.
And I got to say this. Just because it's high fashion don't mean that it actually looks good.
Who deems it high fashion? That's what I want to know.
The people that just put it on there and say it's high fashion. Because you seen them runway shows?
Mm-hmm.
Them shits be ugly, motherfucker, man. I'm like, I would never wear that. I would never wear that.
I feel
who wears that?
Look, I'd be feeling like pause. What's the movie Big Daddy? Like when they in the look when Adam Sandler when they in the park. I just want to go to a fucking fashion show, and when the shit is ugly, just throw a fucking stick or something.
Just throw a stick and let them fall.
Just let them fall.
Just throw a stick right out there on the roadway and just make them just.
When they fall, look at me, fall this shit right up off the goddamn line. Take it right up off the goddamn line.
All of it, man. I think at this point, man, high fashion is just going another direction. Man, it's just, they just.
Look.
Because.
When the common person just wears a good ass. Novelty t-shirt.
Yep.
You see this? Novelty t-shirt. And some fucking jeans or some shorts. That's it.
That's it, man. And you know? It's not that difficult.
I'm a sneakerhead and I'm even tired of the fucking sneaker game.
Like shit. That world has gotten out of hand.
Yeah.
Like even more. But it's just, you know, the high fashion thing, the retail thing. It's like, you know, if you know, I don't care if you know how to dress, if you know your style.
Mm-hmm.
Man, you can go to Walmart, you can go to Target, you can go to, you know, any fucking where, and your whole outfit.
I'm a regular patron in Target.
You know what I'm saying? Like, shit, if you know how to put pieces together, dog, hey,
listen.
Your outfit could be $20.
Listen, bro. Fucking Target shits. All the way down to the hat, to the accessories, man, to all that shit,
I'm
bro.
I'm telling you. I'm telling you, motherfuckers be comfortable. Y'all be, I'm high fashion. But you be walking uncomfortable in the motherfucker. Be uncomfortable, be looking uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. Just, nah, man. Mm-hmm. And it's not saying, don't get this twisted. Like, if I wanted to buy these earrings, I could buy these earrings. If I wanted to buy that fucking trash bag, I could buy it. To me, it's not a smart purchase. To me, that don't make sense.
At all.
I'll go design a trash bag for you.
Listen. Next time I go through Whataburger, and I order for the whole crew, that big ass bag, I ain't gonna do nothing but put another line in inside, reassure that motherfucker,
yeah,
and then put it on the market.
Yeah, man. Yeah,
that is it.
Yeah, because there's some independent designers that are designing much better shit than this than the fashion houses.
Yeah,
and I'm like, we just don't want to support them because. They're not the name, but their shit looks better.
You don't want to support them because they're black. I'm just gonna say that. All right,
facts.
All right, so we look. It's the first week. We might as well get to this shit.
Let's do it.
Might as well get to this shit.
Let's do it.
All the kids are back to school. I love school. I love school. What you say? When I wake up in the morning, I say, ooh.
Who the f- Why did we never ever say anything about that? Why didn't nobody ever say, woo?
No.
Lyrics.
No,
what?
Bro. We woke up in the morning and said, ooh. We just didn't finish the fucking sentence. It was supposed to say, ooh, leave me the fuck alone.
I'm trying to sleep. Lonely too damn early in the morning. What you doing?
What's the mean? He roughing it.
Yes, damn it.
What you say? Nothing.
Nothing.
Dang.
I'm getting dressed.
Ain't you late for work? Shit.
Shit. You taking me today? Okay.
Fuck. Oh man. Which means that you know, we had to endure. All of the first day picks. We're gonna take this in, you know, in steps. We're gonna take this in steps. First, you had to endure the first day picks.
Yes.
On social media.
Yeah.
You know, all the kids and you know, and the uniforms and the haircuts and you know, they new sneakers and you know, the mom. And you can tell how the parents made them take the fucking pictures.
Because they sure don't want to take it.
They don't, you know. The little sideways smirks and head to the side mm-hmm. and pause. And, you know, the nice little lunch boxes and Dragon Ball Z's and, you know, all the, you know, the Caillou's and Blue's Clues and
Paw Patrols
and Backyardigans and, you know,
Legos and Avengers.
And then you got the offbeat, like, you know, my second goddaughter, Yanni, she had, you know, shout out, you know, her first day of pre-K.
Yeah.
You know, she had, like, she just had the unicorn on the front with the glitters or whatever. So cute. So cute. Love it. And then my other goddaughter, you know, she started, like, actual
kindergarten.
Kindergarten, like, yeah. with the big kids. You know, she got the regular-ass backpack now.
Yeah.
Just, you know, yeah. That's, yeah. You know.
That's when they make that change. Like, my son, he had started kindergarten. He's like, Dad, I want a Nike backpack. I said, well, fuck it, son. Yeah, let's get you a Nike backpack, man. You know, you got it, man. I was like, that's all he wanted. He just wanted a Nike backpack. I said, let's get it, son. I'll get you a Nike backpack. And then my daughter, she starts third grade. She gets a JanSport.
Oh, shit.
But here's why she wants the JanSport. She's like, Dad, it's pink with roses. I want that.
Mm.
She didn't care what it was. She said, I just want that one.
The good old JanSport.
Good old JanSport, man.
Had that motherfucker for 19 years.
Man, I think motherfuckers still walking around with their old JanSport.
My shit's in the bottom of the closet.
You see what I'm saying?
With some old folders and shit.
Man, that JanSport, man. You get the all black one with the tan patch at the top.
With the bottom of the shit. Was either the matte black, or like that, look, with the tan, like the cowhide.
That cowhide, they wasn't leather.
It wasn't with the cowhide.
It was the cowhide plaid.
You had the one big pouch, one big zipper,
and
you had the one little pouch
right
in the front.
There at the, that's it.
Good old JanSport.
Old JanSport, man. And you know, it was tough to see everything. This back to school.
Oh.
As I walk my kids in school.
That's what I said. We're gonna take it in steps. So you had the pictures that you took, you know, and the kids are all excited.
They are.
Oh my God. Yes, school. Go to school. Go to school. yes, school. All excited. And you get them in the car.
Yeah.
We're gonna be late. Let's go. You got the whole tribe with them, got the whole village.
Yeah.
Make sure y'all take a lot of pictures. Make sure y'all take. Okay, all right. So we get in the car. We driving. You get on the street of the school, and then you start to see all the cars.
Oh man!
That are arriving at the same time. All the cars.
Oh boy!
So everybody got to find parking spaces now. Mm-hmm. And it's a look. You treat it like this. Like it's East Side High. It's only one way in, one way out.
One way in,
one way out. And so, as you get out the car, kids are still excited.
They are.
You know, you sense a little nervousness because now they're seeing all these other kids walking up. but it's still a little bit of excitement.
Yes, it is.
And then the real fuckery starts.
Yes, it does.
You approach the front of school.
The front of the school is where all the magic happens. And then it spreads throughout the entire school.
First off, bro, how you expect 1,000, 2,000 goddamn students and their parents and their uncles and their aunts and their cousins all to find your name on this little ass piece of paper on the window?
So you got 100 people looking at this glass. Right, you got 100 people looking at this one 8x11.
Yeah,
this one 8x11.
Not landscape, just a portrait.
It's portrait. It is straight up and down.
We're talking printer talk. If y'all don't know, what I'm
saying? Hey, it's portrait with font Times New Roman with font point 12.
Yeah, it's definitely 12.
Okay,
ain't no skips in between either.
No.
Ain't no double space on that paper.
It is single space, single line space, and that is what it is. Right. So you got 100 people looking at this one piece of paper. Trying to rush now, because mind you, we can't forget this, right? The parents still got to go to work.
Yeah. Yeah.
They still got to go to work.
Uh-huh.
So they're kind of in a happy rush of, oh my God, this is so exciting. Come on, we got to get you to school, get you to your class. So they're rushing to try to get their kid to class, but yet they're trying to enjoy the moment at the same time. So you got frantic, happy parents looking at a sheet, bumping into each other. Hey, is this Is this Miss Smith's room? Miss Smith, I mean, come on in. Come on in. So they go into Miss Smith's room and they look around. You got to sign more paperwork when you get it to Miss Smith's room, especially in elementary, mm-hmm. right? So what you thought was going to turn into a five, hey, want to meet the teacher, want to meet you, drop off my baby. Oh, okay, see y'all later. Y'all have fun. Have a great year. And you out. It turns into a whole 45-minute to an out process.
Yeah, because you thought it was going to be this like, okay, bye.
Okay.
No.
Okay, bye.
Listen, and then on top of the fucking paperwork. Now, mind you just said that some of these parents still got to go to work.
Yes, they do.
And this is the fun part for me, and I'm just the uncle, I'm just the godfather tagging along, like just doing my due diligence, you know, of taking the pictures and shit. But I noticed that good old joy in some of these kids' faces. That was at home when they had the good old cereal and the bacon.
Oh, man.
And shit. And they put on the clothes and they had the new backpack and the new lunchbox. And I want to take this with me. I want to take this. Nah, you can't take it because blah, blah, blah. Well, it's the first. You get to that classroom and they sit you in the seat. And you got the little worry on your face. And then the parents are like, okay, well, you have fun with your teachers. This, that, and the other. And then them tears start.
Look.
You get to crying.
Dog. Dog. So, it is the worst sound ever, right? And so what you do is I walk past, I drop my kid off, drop my son off, because you hear it in the early years, like pre-K, right? Kindergarten, maybe first grade. You don't hear it second grade and up. But pre-K, kindergarten, and first grade, just when you hear it.
Second grade and up is them silent tears.
It's the silent tears. Right?
You're trying not to be no punk in front of your classmates.
At all. So you walk past one room. You hear the crying, right?
Mm-hmm.
I saw every black parent do this same thing. Every black parent, as they walk past this room. That was what I saw.
Look, bro.
Don't you dare cry.
Look,
come on.
Look, twofold. I want to play on the pause. I want to play on the part that the parent got to go to work. And the kid, this one kid started crying. Little girl, she was so beautiful. Had a little braids going down.
Oh yeah.
All the way down, the mid back.
Just
beautiful and everything else. But she was at the desk and she was crying. It wasn't a loud cry, not like that. It was silent.
Okay.
But it was just the cry. And the mother at first, the mother was right there like, baby, like, you know, I understand. Like, we got to get together. Remember what we talked about. And the father tried to get down because, you know, it's daddy's girl. You know, the girl. Listen to everything to daddy. Fuck you, daddy. I'm crying, goddammit. So he tries to hug her. And cry over at that. She looked like she's gonna straighten up over there, but then she starts some more. So he's hugging her. And he got this look like, God damn it. My boss told me, one more if I walk in this motherfucker late, I may be fired. My baby girl, they said. And so he get tired of it. He's like, come here. And they go out in the hallway. So I guess the classroom across the hall, he's showing like, so your cousin is right here.
Oh, yeah.
Your cousin going to be right here. But baby, it's going to be okay. Like, you're all right. The teacher got you. It's like her assistant. They're going to take care of it. Like, she was like, fuck you.
Go.
Listen. Either we all go or we all go.
We got to stick together.
We together. It was that one. And it was another kid as we leave it after school. All I heard is the loud crowd. Then I heard that. I said, look, let me get the fuck up out of here. I looked back. I said, that's that cry. Like, I will fuck all this shit up.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. That's exactly what the fuck that meant.
I will fuck all this shit up.
That's exactly what the fuck that meant. Like, keep the fuck on.
I don't know why you tried to bring me into this shit. I'd have had fun for the last five goddamn years just waking up, eating my goddamn cereal. Grandmother done cooked me pancakes and bacon every damn morning.
I ain't even want to be here.
Look, throwing these little blocks and you look in the shapes of what we're getting at. give him a little claps, and then look, and then I'm watching my cartoons until I pass out. Now y'all want to fuck all that up.
I ain't even do nothing.
Look.
Yeah, it's a back to school is an interesting time.
But look, let's get on these parents though.
Hey, so
look, you know, they got people at Walmart. I'm gonna start a website, back to school special.
Because it's two types, man. It's two types though. Back to school special though. It's two types.
Yo,
it's two types. Cause you got the Walmart people, right?
Oh my God.
But then you got the ones that dress up like that. Oh, let me try to find somebody. You got them too that be up in there. They be sprinkled in there with them Walmart people.
And some of them are confused because I done saw bodysuits with bonnets. I done saw head wraps with look with booty shorts and a tank top. Like look,
just trying to figure it out.
Hold on, like I just rolled out of bed. Like I look like I'm in college. I got an 8 o'clock class and I done rolled out at 7:50 just to brush my teeth and get across campus. That's how the fuck they look, bro. Like literally some of the shit.
Yeah.
Some of the shit you just threw on the goddamn. You just threw on the sundress. No bra.
Anything on.
No bra, no panties, no nothing.
Ooh.
I see all that shit.
Just threw anything on. Just said, you know, I'm finna drop my baby out.
Mm-hmm.
You finna go to school today.
Don't embarrass me. I ain't staying in school long. You better not cry. Get in your goddamn classroom. I gotta get back into bed now.
They talk about don't embarrass me, but you embarrassing me with what you got on.
Yes.
That shit work.
Kid rolled up to me. I saw your mama titty. I'm gonna get suspended on the first goddamn day. On the first goddamn day.
I saw your mama titty.
Mm-hmm. Look, and then you always got that one overzealous administrator.
Oh,
that's out on the bus line.
Oh man,
it's a new school year. Are you happy? We're happy you're back.
We're excited. We're excited. Are you excited? I'm excited. You are? Yes. I didn't answer.
Look at the school. Let's go, Tigers.
Let's go. Welcome back, Tigers. We're so excited to have you. Let's go. Gonna be a great year. We're here.
Are you ready to learn?
Woo! Are you here? Because I'm here. Are you on drugs? No, we're happy.
Come on. I need the energy out of you. I need the excitement.
It's gonna be a great 198 days.
Fuck you.
Come on, I've been here since 3:30 this morning.
Oh my gosh, she done had like three venti Starbucks cups and shit.
I'm running on cocaine and coffee. Come on.
Oh my God, bro.
I mean, I have to tell as I go drop my kids. I'm like, hey, man, the sun just came up 30 minutes ago, dog. Can you pipe that shit down?
Listen. But I will say at one of my goddaughter's schools. Dropped off, and of course, you know, they do breakfast a little different these days. Oh. Do breakfast a little different, or at least at that school they did.
Okay.
So like they had the milk and the applesauce.
Okay.
And I guess like this little Cinnabon type deal.
Yeah.
Or
like
that. They had the little trash bags, and they put the shit.
Yeah.
You know, in the trash bags, and they asked you, did you want one? They handed it back. Well, at first, you know, kids, you know, so fucking undecisive. Whatever. At first, she was like, yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I grabbed the shit, you went, no. So I looked at the lady and I was like, she said she didn't want, she said, well, we can't accept it back. Good answer. Great answer with the pox and.
Yeah.
We're at that age, you got to worry about both pox. The COVID.
Yeah, man.
And all this other shit, that was a great fucking answer. Which means that, look, y'all not taking shit back and y'all not spreading.
They've been trained.
Hey.
They've been trained. Mm-hmm. You know, teachers go through enough training. They've been trained, so they know.
I ain't see everybody with no N95s on, though. I ain't see. Yeah,
no, they ain't wearing them. they ain't wearing them shits, though.
They still wearing the blinged out mask.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they wearing the Fashion Nova mask.
Mm-hmm. They are. They definitely are. I have no fucking clue who you are trying to call me right now. But parents, do better. Please do better for your kids.
For your kid. If for anybody.
If for anybody, please do
it for your kid.
And at least put your kid in some kind of daycare or pre-K 4. Yeah. That'll eliminate all that fucking crying on the first day of school.
It will. And if you can, over the summer, put your kid in a couple camps. You know what I'm saying? Don't let him just be at the house sitting all fucking day. You know what I'm saying?
You got to sit with grandma.
Sitting with granny.
Who only going to teach him one through three, numbers one through three before they get frustrated and shit?
That's it. And then granny going to get mad at you, tell you when you coming to get your babies. You know? Like, come on now. I got a bingo tonight. You coming to get your babies?
Oh, shit.
I need to be gone by 3:17. Listen. You need to come get your babies.
So what did y'all do today? Oh, he did wonderful. He counted this morning, and then we watched, Blue's Clues, and, it's the little kids in the backyard. They be dancing and singing. Backyard again. And then he took a nap, and, you're here now. That is it.
Yeah, I fed him a little lunch. Mm-hmm. He ate what I ate, though.
Look, you turn around to your parents, so my kid gonna be dumb. All right. All right, man.
Not that my kid gonna be dumb.
My kid gonna be dumb as fucking rocks.
Oh, man.
Because you ain't got no goddamn patience.
You said
you gonna help. You said you gonna help me out. You said you gonna help me out. And you just had his ass count to three. That is it. And then he fucking watched cartoons all damn day.
Oh, man. That's bad. That's bad. Poor babies.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So we're going to jump into our black-owned business. Now, I'm going to look at black back to school. Just totally different now.
Of course.
Just totally different now. Well, we're going to jump into our black-owned business. Our black-owned business is brought to you by our partners and our sponsors, Assist for You. That's www.4u.com. All right. Take care of all of your, what's up, Green Profuse? Take care of all of your social media and your small business needs. So remember, go to www.assist4u, and that is our partner and sponsor. So this week's Black Owned Business comes to you right out of a funky town, Fort Worth, Texas. All right. Funky town. It is Royal Queen Beauty Bar, all right, right out of downtown Fort Worth, Texas. You can check them out on Instagram at @RoyalQueenBeauty_, all right, or you can go to their website, which is royal-queen-beauty.myshopify.com. Now, they specialize in all of your, and the ladies, this is for you, they specialize in all of your beauty needs, your lashes, your curls, your bundles, lash supplies and lash trays. They specialize in lashes and a supply store trainer and coach. So you can check them out. Make sure that you go to @RoyalQueenBeauty_ and check them out. They offer classes, lashes, reviews, and different products. So that is this week's Black Owned Business of the Week, Royal Queen Beauty out of Fort Worth, Texas.
All right. Now, music of the week. Still ain't Beyonce.
Good.
Still not.
Good.
But y'all know I got something good for y'all. You know, all you hip-hop heads or whatever. Music of the Week comes from none other than, it's a collab. It's Danger Mouse and Black Thought of The Roots.
Whoa.
So it's Danger Mouse and Black Thought of The Roots.
Whoa.
The album is entitled Cheat Code.
Whoa.
Cheat Code. Yes, that's Danger Mouse and Black Thought.
Whoa.
With a collab effect entitled Cheat Code. And I tell you, lyrically and, and production wise, it is a great collab. So go cop that, go check that out. Y'all already know how we do. You know?
Yeah, man.
I'm speaking to the local artists or like the underground or like the indie artists or whatever. If you have any projects that you might want spotlighted, holla at us. DM us at @midweek_vibe right here on IG or on Facebook, everything else. Or if you just want to, cut the bullshit and just email us at vibemidweek@gmail.com.
There you go.
All right. So That includes the black-owned business as well.
As well, yeah. You know, if you got a black-owned business that you want us to highlight, yo, send us that message. Yo, when we'll do our thing, we'll make sure that you get highlighted as well.
You know, like, look, mind you, we said black-owned business.
Black-owned business. Now, look, I'm going to say this. Black-owned businesses, right?
Let them have it. Pause.
Okay. Black-owned businesses. Listen.
Get to them. Pause.
We are offering you, right, a highlight, okay? Now, if you want to come on and talk about your show, that's different, okay? Then we could talk about that. But we are offering you a free highlight on our show and shout-out to help bring you more business and highlight your business in the community, okay? So if we holler at you to try to promote your business, yo, holler back at us so that we can tag and collaborate. And then if you want to come onto the show and spend some time with us, then we could talk about that. But at this point right now, we're trying to offer you a free shout-out and highlight to bring you more audience, to bring you more people.
We're doing, is this thing on me?
It is on you.
We're doing our due diligence to help. Now this, like, you know, whether we collab or whatever the case may be, we're doing our due diligence to bring a spotlight to your business.
Yes.
That will be basically ran and played across the top 7 platforms in the world.
Factory.
Which is Apple Podcasts.
Boom.
iHeartRadio.
Yes, sir.
Pandora.
Yes.
Google.
Yes.
Audible.
Yes.
YouTube.
Yes.
And Spotify.
Boom.
Top 7 platforms in the world. Not to forget that is ran across, you know, IG, Facebook.
Absolutely.
Twitter. Snapchat.
All that.
Only for 24 hours on Snapchat, but still.
But that's it. But, you know, and on the IG stories, too. You get the gist. You get the gist.
Now, we can lead. Never mind. We can lead you to water, but we can't make you drink.
We can't make you drink.
Listen, we want to give back and use our platform to help other businesses.
Yes.
Other businesses, no matter what it is.
Right.
If it's legal.
If it's legal. That's a great point. If it's legal, that's a great, great tag right there.
Joe Byron, they playing.
Don't get us caught up in your debauchery. Midweek was not a part of that. No, the fuck we want.
At all. No.
Nope. Nope.
If your business is legitimate.
Nope.
It's legitimized.
Legitimized day. Legitimized day.
Then we will help you. We will use our platform.
Man, absolutely. Absolutely, man. We are trying to help and give back to our community. But community, you got to holler back at us too, though.
That's it, man. You know, other than that, people, y'all be safe out here in this heat.
Stay hydrated.
Drink your water.
Yeah.
Get your electrolytes.
Your electrolytes.
You know? I don't want to sound like, you know, like that community. Like, you know, eat your fresh, you know, the vegetables and stay away from the GMOs. And
oh, gosh.
Get your sea moss and your Bodak root and your elderberry.
I'll be wanting to ask, well, what do you eat? You telling me what to eat, but exactly. What the fuck do you eat?
Let's play a game, but not it.
Not it.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me with the Rona and
the monkey. Yeah.
And the chicken. Mm-hmm. And the, you see how this shit sound when you say it with the Rona, the monkey and the chicken. all this shit going around. You know? We just forgot about the flu.
We just fuck the flu, right?
Somebody tell me where the flu went.
Where did it go?
We ain't talked about the flu in 3 years.
We haven't. Some bullshit.
We ain't talked about the flu in three years. The
motherfuckers
bro.
Up like, oh, get your flu shot. Now, motherfuckers ain't saying shit about the flu.
Ain't saying nothing about it.
The flu over there looking at sitting in the corner like, damn, man.
I don't even know when the last time somebody got a common cold, bro. When?
I just got. Where the sniffles? Who got the sniffles? Anybody got the sniffles no more?
Ain't nobody said the allergies acting
it's just,
up.
This is my allergies. Like, damn.
It's just the Rona, chicken, and the monkey.
Nothing.
That is it. A Rona, chicken, and a monkey.
God damn. All
right, people.
That's a hell of a zoo.
It is. I'm going to stop fucking with y'all. We're going to get the hell up out of here. All right. If there's nothing else, maybe stand. It's has been another episode of Midweek Vibe. I'm your boy, Cole Bain, and it's Draper Winston.
I am.
Until next week. Peace.
Peace.